What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and yes, we are unboxing again the Lenovo Legion gaming laptop. And the reason why I got this guy in the lab is because when I started doing my research on mining cryptocurrency, I saw a lot of articles dealing with laptops, using laptops as a mining device. Rather than building one, you could use a laptop. And the Legion was one of the laptops that, you know, was mentioned a lot. Top 5, top 10 machines, or top 5 or top 10 laptops that were great when mining cryptocurrency. So the Legion was one of them in that list. So let's unbox this guy, configure it, and see how well it works. All right, so what comes inside that big box? So let's start from here. We have the Legion Get Started booklet. Cool. We have our safety information, you know, little pamphlet. We have our Legion Ultimate Support pamphlet. Inside the box, it actually gives you some nice stickers. That's pretty cool. We have our power adapter, which is actually 230 watts. And we have our heavy gauge power cable. So I'm actually going to take the power cable, hook it up to our power supply. Done. Awesome. So let's put this stuff to the side. Then we have the beautiful Storm Gray Legion 5 Pro 16-inch laptop. Super excited to get this guy in the lab. My main thing is to convert this laptop into a cryptocurrency mining laptop, because it's part of the top 10 list as one of the best mining laptops in 2021. All right, so let's go over some of the ports and features on the Legion 5 Pro. And if you have the laptop facing you to the point that you are able to open it up like this, on your right-hand side, we have a camera switch. We have a 3.2 USB port. On your left-hand side, we have our combo audio jack. And we have a Type-C connection. On the backhand side, we have one RJ45 port. We have a Type-C port. We have two 3.2 USB ports. We have an HDMI, an additional 3.2 USB always-on charging, and we have our power port to connect our power adapter. All right, so let's plug this guy in, turn it on, start getting it set up with the Phoenix mining software so I can start mining on it. And let's get into it. All right, so we just went over some of the ports on the Legion 5 Pro laptop. Kind of excited about getting this guy in the lab, especially I just can't wait to start mining cryptocurrency on it. So let's open this guy up real quick. Awesome. All right, so off the bat, it looks like it does have like an anti-glare display on it. 16 inches, looks beautiful. A full keyboard layout, number pad is over here, power button is at the top. So we're actually going to turn it on to power it on and log in. Awesome. All right, so before we go into the specifications on this machine, let's go over some of the things that I just basically see, right, on the Legion 5 Pro. Okay, full keyboard layout, right? We already went over that. Huge real estate on the trackpad. I mean, it's huge. Wow. Power button is at the top, right? Awesome. There's no fingerprint scanner on this. We do have dual mics, which are located right here at the bottom of the display. At the very top of the 16-inch display, we have a 720 webcam, but it does not have a privacy guard. At the very top of the screen, we have a notch, which allows you to, you know, open it up pretty smooth. Cool. And because I closed the lid, it kind of went to sleep on me. No, wake up. Okay, for brightness on the display, I believe if I hold the function key and F6, this is the brightest. And F5, this is the lowest, which is not that bad. And this is the highest. F6, awesome. I mean, it is not touchscreen. All right, so let's go over some of the specifications on this machine. So we are going to right-click on the taskbar. go to task manager. Let's go to more details. I'm going to open this guy up a little bit. Let's go to performance. Right click on the CPU graph, change graph to logical processor. Now the Legion 5 Pro has the 11th gen Intel Core i7-11800H processor with a clock speed of 2.30 gigahertz, one socket, 8 cores, 16 logical processors. Wow, that's crazy. For memory, it has 16 gigs. It is housing a solid state drive, which is around 500 gigs. Two graphics cards. We have the Intel Ultra HD graphics. And last but not least, we have the NVIDIA GeForce RTX 350 graphics card with 4 gigs of memory, which is awesome because that is the standard requirement for a graphics card to start cryptocurrency mining, 4 gigs and more. So I'm super excited that we have that requirement. So awesome. So we are going to get started and configure this machine so we can start mining with it. All right, so let's get started on configuring this machine to mine. I got my flash drive right here. I'm gonna plug it in on the right hand side because it does have that 3.2 USB port. Cool. And the software that I'm going to use is Phoenix Miner. And there's a couple of things that we need to do on the machine before we even start. So the first thing that I'm gonna do is I'm going to copy this name. I'm going to right click on the desktop, go to new folder, and that's the name that I'm going to give it. It's the same name. The reason why is because we need to tell Windows 10 that the files inside here are safe. Because as soon as you start the mining software and you have your Windows Defender running in the background in real-time protection mode, it's going to see that it is running and it's going to classify the PhoenixMiner.exe file as a malware, and it will stop your mining, and that's the worst thing to do, right? So we are going to add this guy into our Windows Defender. So I'm going to do a Windows I, and from here we are going to go to updates and security, and we are going to go to Windows security. We are going to open up Windows security. From here we are going to click on open app, and the first thing that comes up is McAfee. That's a big no-no. I do not like McAfee, so we are going to remove McAfee. So we are going to go inside the control panel, remove it. So then Windows Defender would be the primary one, and then we could exclude this folder from Windows Defender from even scanning it. So that's what we're going to do. So I'm going to hit the Windows key, go to control panel. Awesome. From here, I'm going to change the view to small icons. And I'm going to go to programs and features, and we're going to look for McAfee uninstall. You're going to get this dialog box. Just click on this, remove all the files, remove it. And I think once it's done, it's going to want you to reboot the system. And right now it's saying Windows Security Threat Protection. Windows 10 is going to automatically turn on Windows Defender for you, which is awesome. So if I click on this dialog box right here, it's already on. If I go to home, now when I go inside virus and threat protection, I'm able to actually go inside manage settings, go all the way to the bottom right here to where it says exclusions, click add or remove. You want to click on add an exclusion. It's going to be a folder. We're going to go inside the desktop. We're going to click on that folder, select that folder, and then we're going to close that up. Now, McAfee is still removing itself. Once it's done, I'm going to reboot the machine. Once I reboot the machine, we are going to continue setting it up to start mining with the Legion 5 Pro. Okay, so the machine finally rebooted. McAfee was removed. If I click on the start button and type in control panel, and I'm really loving the way that the keys feel. Super responsive. That's awesome. Let's go inside program and features, and voila, no more McAfee. And before I restart it, I already added this folder inside Windows Defender exclusion section, so it's not going to get scanned. I won't have any problems at all. So what I'm going to do is double click on this guy and do a control C to copy open this guy up, which is the folder on my desktop, and Control V to paste it over. I'm going to click on the little arrow right here to remove the flash drive. I like to do it old school, so sue me. Awesome, so I'm done with that. Now, the next thing that we need to do on this machine is Windows update. You don't want Microsoft pushing out any Windows updates when you're mining. That's the worst case scenario. You're mining, you're getting good feedback, your hash rate is super high, and bam, the machine needs to reboot. You don't want that. So we are going to click on the start menu, type in service, hit enter there, and we are going to do the following. We need to locate the Windows update service, which is actually located right here. So double click on it, and we are going to change the startup type to disable. We are going to stop it, and we are going to apply the settings. Once the settings are applied, we could click on OK. And the next step that I like to do is Windows I to open up the settings app. And I normally go inside updates and security, go to Windows update. And from here, if you want, you are able to just pause it. And the last thing that I like to do is go inside advanced options. And it's already set to November 6th. So I'm going to extend it to the 13th. Just extend it a little bit more. I'm going to double click on the Phoenix Miner folder. Go inside this folder. And I'm going to right click on start_miner. And we are going to click on edit. And the only thing that I need to do here is make sure that you provide your wallet key and the pool that you're using. All right, these are the two pools that I'm using to mine to. And my rig, I'm actually going to call it Legion 5 Pro. We're going to Control S to save this file. Now, before I double click on it and start the mining, I'm going to move this laptop to a room that has a air conditioner running 24/7. Just to keep it nice and cool. I need to plug in the power supply. Definitely need to plug in the power supply because the graphics card is going to be used. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy. I will come back in a week or two and let you know how it performed. And I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.